All right, lads. Cricket.
Lads, just on behalf of all the lads.
All right.
Lads, on behalf of all the England boys here in Adelaide, just want to wish you all the very best for the final. We're all behind you, and we're desperate for you to beat Aussies in Australia.
You just nicked everything I was going to say there.
Lads, just on behalf of the England cricket boys, I want to wish you all the very best for the final. Desperate to see you beat Australia in Australia at Brisbane. Boys, good luck this weekend in Brisbane. 22 years, and waiting for this moment. Boys, just want to wish you all the very best this weekend in Brisbane. What an achievement to get to the final, to have the opportunity to play against Australia in the backyard and stuff. And
alright, rugby lads, it's cricket lads here.
Lads, just want to wish you all the very best of luck for the final. On behalf of all the England cricket boys, desperate to see you beat Australia in Australia. Very best of luck.
Review, lads! Get in!
Hi, Jimmy Anderson here. This is episode 3 of my tour diary down here in Australia during the Ashes. Lots been going on since the last time I spoke to you. We've been to the rodeo in Townsville, which was very interesting. A few of the lads really enjoyed that. A few of the guys went back the following night. They enjoyed it that much. It wasn't everyone's cup of tea, but it was something different, something worthwhile seeing. You know, it's something that we've never experienced before, so it's quite an interesting thing to go and see.
Let's do it!
We travelled to Brisbane then from Townsville, that was great. There was a lot of build-up to the first test in Brisbane. Obviously, it's a quite a high-profile series. Lots of speculation in the media as to what each team was going to look like in the outcome. And it was our job to try and put that to the back of our minds and really focus on the cricket, which we did really well. We started the game really well. Our first few days went brilliantly. Unfortunately, the day 4 was a tough one for us. But hopefully we can take the positives out of those first 3 days. We played some really good cricket. We're on top for a lot of it. We just need to push home those advantages when we get into good positions. Hopefully here in Adelaide, things will be a bit different. Pink ball under lights, I'm sure it'll be a great event. So there's a very special moment for me just before the start of the first test. Andrew Strauss and Colin Graves presented me with a silver stump ball and silver bales, and all my bowling figures engraved on silver plaques in a frame to recognise my 500 wickets, which is, you know, a very special moment for me and a really nice thing to do. Today I was on media duties, so it involves doing a press conference, TV, radio, newspapers, all at once, one big hit, which was good. There's a lot been going on both on the field and off the field, so there was a lot to talk about, a lot to get through. It went pretty smoothly, I think. Didn't really get asked anything left field. A lot of talk about the pink ball here. You know, as the years have gone on, I've really enjoyed doing sort of things like that, and today was no different. Another thing I'm doing during the Ashes is doing a podcast for 5 Live with Greg James and Felix White, and we recorded that this week in Adelaide.
Jimmy.
Hi.
Your hair looked so good at the Gabba.
Thanks, mate.
Oh, it was a real bit of brightness in an otherwise gloomy 5 days.
I'll take that. I'll take what positives we can out of that game. And if my hair is one of them, then brilliant.
The hair was definitely one of them. Welcome to the Tailenders podcast. This is episode number 3. My name is Greg James. That is Felix White over there. And somewhere in Adelaide is Jimmy Anderson. Hello, Jimmy.
Something a bit lighthearted, a bit fun. My view of the Ashes from over here, and obviously their opinions going into it as well, and kind of takes my mind off obviously the pressurised environment of professional sport. So it's something that I really enjoy doing, and hopefully you guys at home, if you get a chance to listen to it, will like it. So if you fancy listening to the podcast, it's called Tailenders. You can get it on iPlayer, or you can get it on the iTunes under Sports and Recreation. So I'm here with the winner of this week's Ballon d'Ashes, which is Chris Wokes, the Wizard. Congratulations, Chris, well done. How have you felt your week has been in on the football field?
Yeah, okay, not too bad. I mean, I feel like I can still create a few more goals and actually get a few in the back of the net. But no, I thought I linked up well with a few of the players and put in some decent performances.
Nice, mate. You obviously got a nice first touch, but the lads have noticed that you don't really like shooting too much. You feel like you should be scoring more goals than you are?
No, I actually do think that I probably should be scoring more goals than I am, but I also like to assist. Big fan of Mesut Ozil, and you know, he is the assist king, so I take some inspiration from that.
Well, congratulations and good luck for the rest of the tour.
Thanks, Jim.
Oh, this week's nominations. So what we're going to do this week, bit of a change up. We're going to go for the worst player of the week. And I don't think it's going to be much of a competition, but the nominations for the worst player of the week this week are Mason Crane, Mark Stoneman, and another Mark, Ram Prakash. Get your votes in, worst player of the week.